Now, here's where the expert comes in. If you've done that experience once, you have to be able to repeat it. And great people in the world who are uncompromising, they keep working to reproduce the experience. And if you can reproduce that experience over and over again, neurologically and chemically, you will condition your body to become the mind of it. Now it'll be innate in you. It'll be second nature. It'll be easy. It'll be familiar. It'll be common. It'll be automatic. You've done it so many times that it is now who you are. So our jobs then, to go from philosopher to initiate to master. From mind to body to soul. From knowledge to experience to wisdom, and from thinking to doing to being. And you and I have all the biological and neurological machinery to do this. But some people will get all of this information and it'll be philosophical. They'll never apply it. Those people who actually apply it and have the experience once will think that that's defining them. But people who really embody and make it innate in them, the true leaders of the world, it becomes who they are. They don't have to think about leadership. They are leadership. They don't have to think about success. They are success. It's become who they are. So our research, and we've worked with many companies in the United States and in Mexico and in Europe. We've worked with Sony Entertainment. We've worked with Cisco. We've worked with Coca-Cola. We've worked with Pepsi. We've worked with a lot of different companies around the world. And we know that if you give people information, if you give people sound information, and then they can repeat that information, they're wiring it in their brain. They're creating a new model of understanding. If you show them how to apply that information, if they do it properly, they will have some type of transformation. That transformation isn't something that causes people to feel bad or unworthy. It causes them to open their hearts. It causes them to feel joy, to feel gratitude. They feel differently. And if you're able to then create that elevated emotion and you teach people more information, they will continue to transform themselves, and that's called evolution. So, if you think the same thoughts always lead to the same choices. The same choices lead to the same behaviors. The same behaviors create the same experiences, and the same experiences produce the same feelings, and you're now caught in your old self. But new thoughts should lead to new choices, and new choices should lead to new behaviors. New behaviors should create new experiences, and new experiences should create new emotions, and that should inspire evolution. We say that your personality creates your personal reality. And your personality is made up of how you think, how you act, and how you feel. We could say that your personality is your state of being. So now, geniuses, if you keep thinking the same thoughts, keep demonstrating the same behaviors, keep living by the same feelings and emotions, your personal reality is going to stay exactly the same. But if you have new thoughts that lead to new choices, that demonstrate new actions, that create new experiences, that cause you to feel differently, you will begin to walk into a new future. How many people understand this? So most people try to create a new personal reality as the same personality, and it doesn't work. You literally have to become someone else. So, crossing the river of change, going from the old self to the new self, requires you stepping into the unknown. And if you are now in the unknown and you feel uncomfortable because you're leaving guilt behind, you leave unworthiness behind. You see, the biggest problem with most people is they want to create wealth, but they feel lack. They want a new life, but they feel unworthy. That's mind and body in opposition. And our research shows that you can teach people how to recondition their body to a new mind. And when that occurs, they begin to create very powerful things in their life. So now, let's talk about the neuroscience of culture, because there is a neuroscience to it. You have a brain that looks just like the person sitting next to you. And if I was to screw off the top of your heads and take out your brain and your partner's brain, someone sitting next to you, and I went like this, and I set them out, you probably wouldn't be able to tell them apart because you share the same structure in your brain. And we call that universal traits, and we call it gross anatomy. Now, because you share the same brain as the person sitting next to you, you smile when you're happy, you frown when you're sad, you sleep at night, well, this is Mexico, you sleep kind of late at night and get up kind of late in the morning. Come on, I'm kidding. And, you know, you grab a stick the same way, we speak a language, and because we share the same gross anatomy of the brain, we have very universal traits that we have in common. How many people are with me? But now, how your brain is wired is your individuality. And that's the minute architecture or the minute structure of the brain. So then, your brain is wired different than the person next to you because you have different experiences. But if you share the same experiences because you're in a relationship, then you have similar brains that are kind of relating. And relationships are built on common experiences. If we share the same experiences, we share the same emotions. And if we share the same emotions, we can relate with each other. So then, think about it like this. You have a hand. And because you have a hand, you have the same hand as the person next to you. There's only a certain amount of things you can do with your hand. But now, what makes you unique is your fingerprint. That gives you your individuality. And that is really the minute anatomy of something related to a hand. Are you with me? So now, what is the division that unifies both the universal traits and our individual traits? And the answer is culture. Culture. And culture is defined by the environment in which you live, the environment in which you work, the environment of your family. An environment is made up of just a few things. Are you ready? People, objects, things, places, time, pets, and that's pretty much your environment.